Hello everyone, welcome in science class, and today I am going to start chapter 3, that is housing and clothing. Okay, what do you mean by housing, Peter? You all know that we all live in houses. Okay, where do we live? We live in houses. And why do we live in houses? Because houses keep us safe from heat, cold, rain, strong winds and wild animals. That's why we all live in houses. Houses are of different types depending on the material used to build them. Okay, again I am repeating these points. Where do we live? We all live in houses. Why do we live in houses? Why do we need a house? Because we need a house because it keeps us safe from heat, cold, rain, strong winds and wild animals. Houses are of different types depending on the material used to build them. For that, we will do one activity here which is given in book. If you have books, so you can open that and you can see. In this activity, we will see how kachcha houses made up of and how pakka houses are made up of. Can you tell me how kachcha house is made up of? Yes. Kachcha house is basically made up of mud, straw and wood. What do you mean by mud, straw and wood? Wood, bitter, you know very well, it is a part of plant. So that is wood. Lakdi jisko aap bolte ho. Straw, these are the thin stems. Okay, and mud basically is known as sand. So kachcha houses are made up of mud, straw and wood. Now we will see how pakka houses are made up of. Pakka, we all live in pakka houses, and you can say here kachcha house is like a temporary house. Okay, kachcha house are like temporary house and pakka house are like permanent house. So if I will ask you a question, where do you live, in which kind of house you live? Are you living in a temporary house and are you living in a permanent house? Yes, you are living in a permanent house because they are made up of steel, bricks and cement. So those houses are made up of steel, bricks and cement. They are called as pakka house, permanent house. Okay, now we will see house fort and bungalow. How house forts are made up of? What is this? A house which is on board, that is called as house fort, and which is basically in Srinagar we see. In Srinagar mostly house forts are there because if there are some streams and you know water resources on that, so we can use this house fort. Bungalow, what do you mean by bungalow? Bungalow, yes, it is also a kind of permanent house which is made up of brick, cement, sand and steel. That is bungalow. Now we will see igloo and caravan. How igloo is made up of? It is a house which is made up of ice. Okay, where Eskimos live. In igloo, Eskimos live. And caravan, a house on wheels. That is called as caravan. So what did you learn from it, Bita? Where do we live? We live in houses. Why do we need a house? A house, we need a house to keep us safe from heat, cold, rain, strong winds and wild animals. Okay. Then next, how houses are of different types depending on the material used to build them. There are different kind of houses which is made up of different kind of things. It is made up of that. Now we will discuss the qualities of a good house. See, we all live in houses and our house are good. And which kind of qualities our houses have? Let's see about it. So here, now we will see some qualities of good house. So first quality is, a good house should have doors and windows. Why should the house have doors and windows? Because doors and windows allows to let air and sunlight in. Okay, that's why all the houses should have doors and windows. Now, next quality is, we should have open spaces in our houses. If we will have open spaces in our houses, so our house would be aired. So, open spaces like balcony, veranda and lawn make a house air. Aapka jo house hai, wo airy hoga if you will have these things in your your houses, balcony, veranda and lawn. So this is very important that we should have open spaces in our houses. Now next quality is, our house should be kept clean. You can see your mother also, she always cleans the house. Why she is cleaning the house? Because it is very very important to make our houses germs free. Because if the germs would be there, so we can have many diseases. Okay, so it is very important to keep clean the house. Okay, a clean house help us to stay healthy, and it is very important if we are having a clean house, so we can keep ourselves healthy also. Okay, next, doors and windows should be fitted with wire mesh. Wire mesh means, here I am writing another meaning, wire mesh. Why doors and windows should have wire netting better? Because if we will have wire netting on the doors and windows, so wire netting basically allows the air and sunlight inside the room, and it stops the entry of so many insects like mosquitoes and flies. So it is very important to have wire netting on doors and windows, because if inside room if you are sitting, so you can feel the fresh air and sunlight, and that should be free from mosquitoes and flies. So we should have doors and windows should be fitted with wire netting. Now next quality is, it should have proper drainage system. Proper drainage system, why should we have proper drainage system? Because the drainage system carries dirty water away from the house. What is drainage system? This drainage system we have fitted with the bathroom and from the kitchen. So where we do many things, and the waste water, the dirty water goes through the pipe. So we should have drainage system, because that carry dirty water away from the house, and that should be proper. Okay, means maintained hona chahiye, wo cover hona chahiye, khula hua nahi hona chahiye. Now next is, a good house should have green plants around it. You know very well that how green plants are important for our life. If green plants would not be there, so the fresh air, fresh oxygen we would not get to breathe. So this is very very important to have green plants in our house to get enough oxygen. Okay, let's see again all the qualities of a good house. First is, a good house should have doors and windows. Second, open spaces like balcony, veranda or lawn make a house clean. A house should be kept clean. A clean house help us to stay healthy. Doors and windows should be fitted with wire mesh. It should have proper drainage system that carries dirty water away from the house. And the last one is, a good house should have green plants around it. Let us learn how to keep a house clean. Now we will see some points. With the help of these ways, we can keep our house clean. So let's start. First point, a house should be swept and mopped every day. What do you mean by mop? Means to clean the floor every day. We should clean the floor every day. Why should we keep the floor every day? Because there are so many germs wherever we walk on the floor. So maybe we can have some impurities in our leg. So our house can be dirty, so it is very very important to clean it every day. Okay, next point is phenyl. Phenyl should be added. There is a liquid that we should add into the water whenever you are cleaning the floor, whenever you are moving the floor. What is that? That is phenyl. Phenyl should be mixed with water to warm the floor, because this keeps the germs up. All the germs which are present, so it basically removes all the germs from our houses. So it is very important to mix phenyl into the water whenever you are having mopping on the floor. Okay, next point is, garbage should be thrown into the dustbin. Where should you throw the garbage? Yes, you should all covered with lids. Why it should be covered with lids? Because if you will throw the garbage, and maybe garbage are of two types, the dry waste and the wet waste. So if you will throw the wet waste into the dustbin, so maybe so many flies can fly over there. So it can cause many diseases. So you should always cover the dustbin whenever you throw the garbage. Okay. Next is toilets, bathrooms, and wash basins should be cleaned regularly. Every day basis, on every day, you should clean the toilet, bathrooms, and wash basins. It is very, very important because so many germs are present there. So it is very important to clean these areas inside our house. Okay. Next is drains of kitchen and bathroom should be well covered to keep cockroaches and mosquitoes away. Drainage system, I told you. Drainage system is a system by which the dirty water, it carries the dirty water, and which we are just using it to throw the water away. So it is very important to cover these areas, because in these areas so many cockroaches and mosquitoes breeds, so they can come into our houses. So it is very important, so it should be covered so that they can be away from our houses. Okay. Next is, things should always be kept at their right place. Always you should keep your things at the proper place so that you can get the things on time. Okay. Now, so again we will see these points. What was first? A house should be swept and mopped every day. Every day you should do mopping. Next is, phenyl should be mixed with water to mop the floor. This keeps the germs away. Okay. Next, garbage should be thrown into the dustbin. Dustbin should be kept covered with lids. Toilets, bathrooms, and wash basins should be cleaned regularly. You should always clean these areas. Next, drains of kitchen and bathroom should be well covered to keep cockroaches and mosquitoes away. Things should always be kept at their right place. Thank you. Okay, beta. So today in homework, you have to read this chapter till here, and you have to find out the hard words, and you have to write those hard words in your fair notebook with very neat and clean handwriting. Okay, thank you.